My name is Ben Chaish. I'm a wedding and elopement photographer based in the Pacific Northwest. And recently I changed everything about this office setup, from obviously the desk and just the backdrops and everything, and wanted to give you guys kind of a glimpse into this. I did a ton of research, watched countless hours of YouTube desk setups and things like that, and wanted to share kind of how I set up all my stuff, why I set it up, why I chose the things that I did, and give you kind of an idea of why I moved from a really simple editing setup to a setup that's really functional, versatile, and allows me to have a little bit of movement during the day as well. So for the past few years, I've been using an IKEA bar table as my standing desk. I knew that as someone who is really active in my actual job as a wedding photographer and an elopement photographer, most of my work is normally hiking up mountains and just being pretty active. But then I would come back and sit and just felt really a big disconnect between those two things. And so once I moved into this office that we built in my backyard, which I will hopefully do another video about more specifically, I knew that I wanted to get a desk that was much more adjustable and also had the ability to sit and stand. So when I decided to sort of redesign my office to be more functional for all of my random content creation stuff, I definitely decided that I was gonna go for a sit-stand desk, and I researched a ton. I watched a ridiculous amount of these videos on YouTube and came across a company called Fully out of Portland. So they're sort of local to me, and what I found in all their stuff really made me excited. One of the other things that I really loved about Fully, and one of the reasons I'm sort of really proud to be partnering with them in this, is that they are actually a certified B Corp, which I've done a ton of research on, and you can definitely look it up and I'll link below what that actually means. But essentially it means that they're just a company that is committed to sustainability and ethical. And for someone that spends a ton of time out in the environment and sort of relies on that for my way of life and business, it's something that was really, really unique and, to be honest, just sort of admirable about their company. So I reached out to Fully and they were more than kind enough to send over a ton of amazing stuff to sort of deck out this office. That being said, one of the things that I'm really, really particular on is that I will never do a review or any type of video promotion or anything like that in any way of something that I was not already planning on buying myself. Or if something else came up that I would spend my money on that I didn't know existed, then of course I'd be into that too. I was pretty dead set on getting a Jarvis standing desk from Fully, and it just so happens that they were obviously generous enough to send this stuff over. And another thing to note is that you'll probably notice that this is an L desk. So it has this section right here as well as this back portion. I had always just had, you know, larger desks. I'm used to just having, not necessarily clutter, but there's just a lot of things that I do and I need a lot of prep space. And in my previous desks, I'd always had either two next to each other or two in this kind of configuration. And one of the things I really like about it is the idea that I can have more flexibility, but then I also really do like having my monitor and things like that in the corner, which leaves then this space for me to film a lot of the videos that I do for Patreon and for just other things in general, because it allows me to have this as a space for this backdrop. And then I often use the space behind me that I'm currently blocking with auxiliary things. Sometimes I'll have a laptop over there, sometimes I'll have gear being prepped, all sorts of stuff. I just really love having the extra space. I could definitely stick this in a corner or whatever, but I do like having this kind of sticking out and allowing me to have some space as another backdrop. Kind of breaks up the middle of the room. So obviously the best part about having a standing desk is the ability to just simply stand. I had a few friends that had kind of some older desks, and like, you have to like really push hard to get this thing to move at all. A lot of the sit-stand desks that I had seen in the past were just super flimsy, and like at max height, it just felt like you couldn't even write because everything was so, I don't know, just troublesome in that way. I would assume as well that the L desk, because it gives another point of contact, allows you to have a little bit more stability as well. So I would assume, again, I'm not the expert here, but I would definitely assume that because I have 3 points of contact with the ground, that it's gonna make this thing even more stable. And that has absolutely been the case. Again, I can't imagine it being any more stable, which is pretty crazy considering the fact that it's, you know, this high and can move all the way back down. So I was going to just wait to transition this thing, but I figured I'd give you kind of what it actually sounds like for this thing to move up and down. It's not like I'm gonna be recording a podcast and then in the middle of it, move it up and down. But I will say it is not nearly as loud as I thought it was going to be, which again, it's, I don't even know how long that was, just a few seconds to get from the normal standing height to this height, but kind of a bonus. It's not super loud. I don't hear the little motors in here like really working too hard. So yeah, A plus on that front. Now, this desk setup thing obviously wouldn't be anywhere near complete without mentioning this chair, which is ridiculous and also amazing. When I first started talking to Fully about this whole desk setup, one of the things that came sort of highly recommended in this complete kit was this chair. It's by Hogg and it's called the Capisco. So sort of the brilliant thing in this for me is specifically that it is just like a different weird chair. It's definitely ergonomic and it's not one of those chairs that you're gonna just wanna like sit down and instantly sink into and like watch a movie or something like that. But at the same time, I think that's what makes the chair amazing. It definitely has a lot of different things that you can do with it. You can sit here sideways, and it definitely makes you feel like you can sit at the front of it, sit in the back. And I find that I've never been uncomfortable sitting in this chair, but I'm also always moving. It kind of gives me the idea that I can sit back, do all these things. I know it seems kind of ridiculous, but I think that's what I like the most about Fully's brand and their whole kind of overall encompassing thing is that every single piece of kit that I got for this desk setup encourages me not to just sit on my butt all day long. Sometimes what I'll do is if I'm doing maybe a podcast or something that I want to be standing for an extended period of time, I'll just lift this up and allows me to just kind of rest on it a little bit, and it's ended up being pretty helpful. Now, as someone who always loves to be organized but has sometimes a trouble staying organized, one of the things I definitely made sure to add was this little drawer here, just to keep those little knicks and knacks and cables and things like that to have a place on the desk so that I'm not just fumbling around with just junk everywhere. So now that we've talked about the desk and the chair, there's one last piece to this kind of moving, standing, sitting desk puzzle, and that's a couple of things that are actually under the desk. So what I'm currently standing on is called the Move Mat. And it's called the Move Mat for a reason. It is sort of like a, you know, standing relief cushy mat. But the thing that's unique about this one in particular is that it is uneven and has a bunch of little, I don't know if they're little balls or ridges or what underneath. And the thing about that is it's kind of like you're just kind of giving yourself a foot massage all day long. I've been told that it's kind of meant to mirror walking through like the forest floor. It might be better for you to be standing, but it's not gonna be great for you if you're standing and completely immobile. So with this Move Mat, it definitely helps kind of relieve the pressure on my feet. I definitely can stand all day long if I wanted to on this thing, but it also continues to get me to move back and forth. It is kind of weird because I don't wear shoes when I'm on this, so maybe it's not compatible with all offices if you are working with other people, but for me, it's been a really cool thing to be able to have this pad and again, another thing that sort of encourages movement. I love the standing desk, but sometimes there's something about sitting that allows me to just deep focus a little bit more. So sometimes if I'm working on tax stuff or accounting things or whatever, and I just have to crunch more numbers and have less distractions, I'll sit down. But just because I'm sitting doesn't mean I'm not moving, because I have this little thing that, is technically an elliptical, but I use it almost like a sitting bike. So I can sit there, do some pedaling, and keep my body moving in the process. All right, so let's talk real quick about what's actually on the desk. Behind me, this massive thing is actually the 2014 27-inch 5K iMac. As a photographer, I just love seeing that big screen, having that extra real estate. So even if you have a MacBook or a MacBook Pro or any sort of laptop, I definitely highly suggest having a larger screen so you can see a little bit more detail. And for me, I find that to be really, really beneficial. So I know as a traveling photographer, I'm in sort of a unique position where I have multiple computers for multiple different uses, but my secondary computer is the 2016 MacBook Pro with the 4 USB-C ports and then the touch bar. I definitely don't use the MacBook Pro as much when I'm at home, but when I travel, this thing sees a ton of use. The next thing on the list is something that I'm considering seeing if I can actually replace the MacBook Pro with, and that is the 2020 iPad Pro 11-inch. I just find that I love note-taking with the Apple Pencil. I used to have just stacks and stacks of notebooks and stuff like that, and being able to have them all kind of consolidated into here, and the fact that you can actually modify your notes and kind of go through and erase and put things in different lines and make things bigger and smaller, it's helped me a lot. Having Photoshop and Lightroom on this as well makes it a ridiculous computer. And I really do love using the Apple Pencil to make kind of fine adjustments and brush things like that. It ends up being a really cool little thing. And then the next bit of tech that's here on my desk is this Rode PSA arm with this Rode pod mic. I actually don't have a podcast yet. It's something that I am sort of working on. We'll see if it happens, but I've actually been a guest on a podcast that I just hated how my voice sounded going through non-microphones. And I figured throwing this on the desk, it's able to be out of the way, but also it allows me to do voiceovers, all sorts of other things. And I love that I can just record the audio directly into the computer, so then when I can take that audio, plop it straight in. A lot of times when I'm doing tutorials for Patreon or things like that, I will have this microphone just right here and I will just be able to easily sync up everything in post. As long as you don't mind it being in the shot, it ends up being a fantastic sounding microphone and whole setup. I run this microphone through a Focusrite Scarlett Solo that just USB-Cs directly into the iMac. It has two inputs, one for a microphone and one for a guitar, which also has been helpful as I've been playing music at church, just in my office and recording it solo. I also think it sounds great. It doesn't color the audio too much. And for just over $200 between the microphone and the audio interface, I think it is a pretty great setup. To monitor this audio, I just have a pair of Sony MDR7506s. Back in the day when I actually played a lot of music and did a lot of recording, these were in basically every music studio in the world. They're around $100, but they're really good at kind of monitoring your audio, and they're not coloring it. They're not giving you extra bass or anything. I wouldn't say they're actually great to listen to music with, but to record audio and get a really good clean sound, to know what you're getting out of this, they have been really great for me. So moving on to the other kind of stuff in here, I use a loop deck for editing my photos. I did an entire video on this little device. It's an editing keyboard that kind of works like a musical keyboard for me. It makes me feel like I'm playing an instrument and a lot less like I'm working on photos. So it ends up being a really cool thing. You can check that out. And then I'm still just sticking with the regular Magic Keyboard and the regular Magic Mouse from Apple. They've been great for me, no issues with them, so why fix what isn't broken? Now, one of the other things that I have on this desk is obviously my phone, but one of the ways that I like to have it on here is on this little stand. It allows me to have my phone there. It's at an angle where I can actually see it, and it gives me the notifications that I need by just looking at it. It'll unlock and everything. And it's obviously a wireless charging stand from Anker. just solid, small little piece of tech that I highly recommend for anybody that's looking to have their phone on their desk. I also keep a few random things on my desk and usually at least one camera. I'm personally just inspired by cameras, and so the camera that I have on my desk right now is my Leica M6 with a 50 millimeter Summilux. If you follow this channel at all, you'll know that this is the kind of stuff I talk about on here most of the time. So obviously I have a great affinity for these kind of things. So keeping cameras that I love on my desk nearby, almost just for visual inspiration, is something that I just love to do. I've also recently, I know, been way behind on the times, but converted to AirPods. They're super good for just phone calls and meetings and stuff like that real quick. And with the new Apple software releasing soon, being able to automatically switch from your iPhone to your Mac to your iPad, they're just gonna get better and better. One of the last things we'll talk about is just another thing that I'll actually turn down the lights to be able to show a little bit better, but it's just this IKEA lamp that I keep on my desk. I have a LifeX bulb in it. I'm sure it's sort of similar to those Philips Hue bulbs, but it allows me to change the color temperature on it to kind of give me a really warm look, or sometimes and usually a more clean daylight look to just, yeah, give my office and my desk a little bit more light and a little bit more dynamics. It looks good in video and photo stuff, but also it just does kind of break up the flatness of what can be on the desk. One of the final things that I'll mention about this desk is the fact that it is made for power, but it has some kind of interesting and fun little ways to get me power as well. So the first of these two things is a small clamp power strip that gives me three outlets as well as a USB-C and USB-A. The amazing thing about this is that you get USB-C at PD 45 watts. So it's enough to actually power a MacBook or an iPad. It's a little bit less than the 61 watts that my MacBook Pro actually draws. So you can definitely put the brick on there, but it will still power and charge my MacBook Pro, which in a pinch is a really, really great little option. I also have a powered grommet where, you know, those little holes where the wires go through. Instead of having that hole right here, I have another outlet as well as a USB-C and USB-A port. So when I'm prepping for a wedding or an elopement, I can plug a small power strip in here, or I have a couple adapters that'll take the single USB and multiply it. It's just a really, really convenient thing to not have to plug a bunch of stuff into walls. I can just set up my stuff right here on this portion of the desk, prep, and make sure I'm good to go. And then finally, if you've actually watched any videos that I've done on this channel, you definitely recognize this whole thing. This is actually a side table by Fully that is made of the same wood, same material, so it gives me a really good cohesive look in my studio and can give me a cohesive look in my videos. I've actually added casters to it as well, so I can move this to different parts of the office. I can move it back and use it as a table just to work on things, or I can just, you know, move it back to here. Having this has been a super, super good way to just bring this whole thing together as well. So thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions about any of the stuff, and there was a ton of it, let me know in the comments below. I know that when I was trying to decide all of this stuff, I had a ton of questions and spent a ridiculous time watching videos like this on YouTube. So if you have any questions about literally anything that I talked about here, let me know, because I would definitely love to answer and help out. And if you like this video as well, I'm planning on doing a full office tour that encompasses way more of how I kind of like laid everything out and why I put things where, all of my other filming gear. And if you are into cameras and photography and gear and you just came here to learn about office equipment, I make a ton of videos about photography gear, a lot of film stuff, a lot of things with Leica cameras, Hasselblads, all that kind of stuff. If those words mean anything to you, subscribing to this channel would probably be a really good idea. So again, a huge thanks to Fully for completely helping me deck out my office. It is legitimately kind of like a dream setup for me, having a really great ergonomic chair, having a table desk that moves up and down, can just help me film. There's a ton of stuff that has been amazing for me over the past few months of having this setup, and I honestly couldn't be more thankful. So thanks again, and I will see you guys in the next one.